Welcome to The Next Fight. I'm Don West, National Trial Counsel for CCW Safe. Today we'll talk about being searched after a self-defense incident. Generally, when someone is arrested, they can be searched without a search warrant. Anything found on their person can be seized as evidence and used to prosecute them, even if it's unrelated to the reason for the initial arrest. For example, if you're arrested for the self-defense incident but have drugs or an illegal weapon on you, you can be prosecuted separately for that, even if the self-defense case is dropped later on. Items on you or around the scene will be seized for examination later in labs, perhaps, even if it's not contraband or otherwise illegal. For example, you can be certain that the police will take your cell phone and will want to examine it to see if there's anything of evidentiary value on it. The Supreme Court recently said that while the police will be able to take the phone at the scene, they'll need a search warrant to actually search the contents of your phone unless you give them permission to search it without a warrant. And that brings me to the next point. Should you consent to a search of your phone, your car, your computer, or your house? My advice is almost never. Although there are circumstances when the police can legally perform searches without a warrant and without consent, if a warrant is needed and you don't give consent, the police will need to convince a judge that there's probable cause for the search and go to the trouble of preparing a detailed sworn affidavit and a proposed search warrant. That process can sometimes take several hours. It's a pain in the neck to do, and often the police won't make the effort unless they feel strongly that it's worth it. However, when you consent to a search, you're telling the police that they don't need to bother getting a warrant. They don't even need probable cause. In fact, they don't need any legal reason at all because you just gave them permission. The police love that. It makes their life so much easier and guarantees that what they find can be used in court. Once you give permission, you're on the hook for whatever they find, even if they didn't have a legal basis for the search without your permission. There's very little to be gained from consenting to a search, and potentially a lot to lose. Why give up your rights just to make their job easier? And on top of that, lose any opportunity to challenge the legality of the search. Sure, it may make you uncomfortable to refuse permission, especially if the police have been treating you well up to then, and you really believe you don't have anything to hide. If you don't want to be direct, just say that you have a friend who's an attorney and he says not to give consent to search, so that's what you're going to do. However, there's one exception I can think of. If you're being accused in a defense shooting and you're asked for a breath test or a blood sample, and you know for sure that you don't have any illegal drugs in your system and you haven't been drinking, I think it's a good idea to cooperate and to consent to the breath or blood test. In fact, just like you would want the police to photograph any injuries you have from defending yourself, if you're involved in a self-defense shooting, I think it's a good idea to request a blood or breath test to prove that you aren't under the influence of anything. Because down the road, a negative breath test and blood test will be very helpful to your credibility when you explain how your actions were reasonable when you had to defend yourself, and now you can show that your judgment wasn't impaired by alcohol or drugs. Thanks for watching. I'm Don West for The Next Fight.